Once upon a time, long ago, there lived a mother and her son. They was very poor.
My name is Mother, and this is...
Jack!
One day, the mother said to Jack,
"We can't even afford to buy a loaf of bread, and we're going to have to sell our cow!"
"Okay, Mother, I'll take the cow to the market and sell her."
On the way to town, Jack came across a strange man walking along the road.
"Hello there, boy. Where are you going?"
"I'm going to the market."
"What have you got to sell?"
"My cow. She's just catching up. You interested in buying her?"
"Yes, but I've only got these 9 magic beans."
Okay.
Jack and the man traded. Jack was so excited, he ran all the way home carrying his 9 beans.
"Mom, look what I got for our cow. 9 magic beans."
Jack's mother became very angry with Jack.
"What? How could you be so stupid? You're such a simpleton! I raised an idiot! There's no such thing as magic beans! Give them here!"
Mother wrenched the 9 magic beans from Jack and hurled them out of the window into the garden. Jack and his mother did not have anything to eat for dinner that evening, so they finished their chores and went to bed. The next morning, Jack and his mother had a humongous surprise. During the night, the 9 beans had sprouted. They had grown into a thick beanstalk so tall it pierced the clouds.
"I'm so hungry. I didn't have anything to eat last night. Hey, I wonder if there's a McDonald's up there."
So Jack climbed up the beanstalk.
"I wonder where it ends."
Meanwhile, back on the ground.
"Jack! Jack! Where are you? I never could control that boy."
He climbed and climbed and climbed all day, until he passed through the clouds and arrived at the very top. There, he found a silver road. That led to a large wooden door. When Jack knocked, a tall woman opened the door.
"Wow! Hello! What do you want?"
"Please, ma'am, I'm hungry and thirsty."
"You'll be worse off if you don't go away. My husband will be home soon and he likes to eat little boys."
"I'm starving."
Suddenly, the earth shook with the giant's footsteps. Terrified, Jack darted into the house.
"Quickly, hide in here."
Jack climbed into the oven as the giant thundered into the kitchen. Shortly after, the woman closed the door.
"Fee-fi-fo-fum, I smell the blood of an Englishman. Be alive or be dead, I'll grind his bones to make my bread."
"Nonsense, you're just dreaming. You must be smelling the stew from last night. I'll bring you some."
"What's this? Bring me my magic hen."
The woman brought the giant his magic hen. Jack peeked out of the oven and watched the hen lay one golden egg after another. Soon, the giant was fast asleep and snoring. Jack quietly grabbed the magic hen, but the hen cackled loudly and woke the giant.
Come back here, you thief!
He climbed down the beanstalk, but the giant was close behind him. When he was near the bottom, he shouted,
"Mara, give me an axe! Just bring me an axe! No, I said an axe! An axe!
How about this? Now that's what I call a saw."
He took the axe, the saw, and chopped down the beanstalk. Down, 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 tumbled the giant, and with a mighty crash, he hit the ground. Jack and his mother lived happily ever after, and thanks to the golden eggs, they never needed anything ever again.